This is He Knows Everything, bringing you the heat that far. We keeping a foot on the what? On the Knicks. We keeping a foot on the what? On the Knicks. Let's talk about it, man. I told you guys what's happening. And a prediction king strikes again. So hold up. Terence Crawford rematching Errol Spence. It's a things that make you say, It's a things that make you say, But in its most cold-hearted, unadulterated, cutthroat truth-teller fashion, let's talk about it. He said he'll rematch him under one condition. Why is he saying that? See, what boxing fans need to come to the conclusive state of, what they need to come to the underlining of, the first fight was a cockamamie fake fight. It wasn't a real fight. It was a show. It was a circus soleil. It was a circus show. It was a clown show. And that's what you guys are getting. The clown show. The Cirque du Soleil. The Las Vegas Strip of a Cirque du Soleil that shows you that it's a show in of itself. See, Devontae Tank Davis said Errol Spence was drunk. Michael Jai White said, Errol Spence, I have inside information that says that Errol Spence really wasn't the Errol Spence that was the Errol Spence that night. See, Terence Crawford's career is defined by Errol Spence. It's defined by the truth. And see, one thing we've learned with the conclusive state of the truth is the truth hurts, but the truth will set you free. And those whom the truth set free are free indeed. Let me say it again. The conclusive state of the truth is the truth hurts. And those whom the truth set free are free indeed. But when we say this, we don't say it because the vernacular of the truth sounds good. We say this because this has biblical sounding of proof and evidence that is associated and put behind it. So then we have to ask ourselves the underlining dichotomy that is associated with it. And what's that? Terence Crawford has always been what he's always been. And you know what that is. A chihuahua barking behind the damn fence. Let me say it again. A chihuahua. But a stifling chihuahua. Notice the throat. Barking behind the damn fence. Because when it's all said and done, did he really win so definitive to the point to where he put himself on such a superstar standpoint? Or was he gifted a win? Because why can't he land the fights that he wants? It's the things that make you say, Why can't he get the Canelo fight? It's the things that make you say, He cannot get these things because behind the dark sport of boxing, behind controversy that's associated behind the sport, everyone knows that when it's all said and done, he didn't really do the heavyweight lifting. He drowned and put a guy in a position that was at a weight class longer than he needed to be. So of course he's in a definitive position to win the fight. But did he actually win the fight? You see, if you're not a brain full of mush and a brainwashed dodo head, if you're using your boxing knowledge, if you're using the true boxing eye test, if you're using your corpus callosum, your cerebellum, your medulla oblongata, if you're using your ability to effectively and reasonably think, if you're using all cylinders that are clicking on all levels, you would understand why He Knows Everything is said what He Knows Everything is said behind this. You would understand why Michael Jai White said what he did by putting his celebrity status on blast. His reputation on blast. His identity on blast. his celebrity, his fame, his Hollywood ship on blast via Vlad TV. Because that's a place where people expose themselves. Notice there hasn't been anything negative. There hasn't been no negative traction behind that. It's because Michael Jai White understood. No, he understands that what he said had weight and validity behind it. Because he had traction. It's like a tire. When a tire has traction, it can drive with fluidity. But when a tire doesn't have traction, what happens? It wiggles. It jiggles. And then it gets into a car crash. Let me say it again. It wiggles. It jiggles. And then it gets into a car crash. Because it's tractionless. Just like the first fight with Errol Spence versus Terence Crawford. It was a tractionless fight. So we have to see how Errol Spence fighting Sebastian Fedora and Terence Crawford fighting Israel Madrimov gets them both a belt and then puts them in the common denominator, in the equalizer of them fighting a Crawford versus Spence rematch. See, you have to understand what makes Al Haymon Uncle Al. You have to understand why He Knows Everything is the remix version of Al Haymon. Because Al Haymon, killers move in silence. And you have to understand his business acumen and his savvy. Build Terence Crawford up to shoot his rabbit ass back the fuck down. Let me say it again. Build Terence Crawford up to shoot his rabbit ass the fuck back down. That's business 101, supply and demand. Terence Crawford wasn't a household name. So how do you make him a household name? You put him in a position to where he beats a guy that he wasn't supposed to beat. And now you have all of his cockamamie fans thinks that for a second, the unthinkable, a chihuahua, a chihuahua barking behind the fence can actually come behind the fence and bark. But we all understand chihuahuas are meant to be behind the fence. And the reason why they're meant to be behind the fence is because they bark behind a damn fence. They're never meant to come around the fence. They don't have the audacity. They don't have the unmitigated gall. And they don't have the veracity to go up against the Tibetan Mastiff of an Errol Spence. To go up against a Megalodon Shark. A Megalodon Shark has no predator. It is the predator. But when you're on snacks, when you're on PEDs, when you are enhanced, when you're able to sit there and showcase all press conferences, post conferences of roid rage. When you're able to load and pad your gloves, of course you can win a fight. And then you fight a guy that's weight drained and high as fuck. How are you not going to win that? So really, when it's all said and done, did Terence Crawford really beat Errol Spence? Or did the best Errol Spence really show up? Slim Shady said it best. Where the real Errol Spence, please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up with a real Errol Spence. Please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up with a real Errol Spence. Please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up with a real Errol Spence. Please stand up. Please stand up. Because when it's all said and done, boxing fans are asking, did the real Errol Spence please stand up? So when it's all said and done, what's not cold-hearted about this? What's not unadulterated about this? And what's not the cutthroat truth teller fashion? So really, when we look at the rematch, we understand we're going to get a real fight in the second fight. This is He Knows Everything. Checking out.